वेलकम बैक टू योर फेवरेट चैनल मैथ हेल्पर। वी विल डू क्वेश्चन नंबर 19 टुडे, केस स्टडी बेस्ड क्वेश्चन। सी हियर, एप्लीकेशन ऑफ पैराबोलास हाईवे ओवरपास अंडरपास अ हाईली हाईवे अंडरपास इज पैराबोलिक इन शेप। नाउ शेप इज गिवन, इट इज शेप ऑफ पैराबोला। पैराबोला इज अ ग्राफ दैट रिजल्ट फ्रॉम पी एक्स इज इक्वल टू ए एक्स स्क्वायर प्लस बी एक्स प्लस सी एंड इट इज सिमेट्रिकल अबाउट अ वर्टिकल लाइन। इट इज सिमेट्रिकल अबाउट अ वर्टिकल लाइन एंड दैट इज नोन एज एक्सिस ऑफ सिमेट्री। नाउ एक्सिस ऑफ सिमेट्री रन्स थ्रू द मैक्सिमम और मिनिमम पॉइंट ऑफ द पैराबोला विच इज कॉल्ड द वर्टेक्स। नाउ ए पार्ट, इफ द हाईवे ओवरपास इज रिप्रेजेंटेड बाय एक्स स्क्वायर माइनस टू एक्स माइनस एट देन इट जीरोज आर। सो दिस यू कैन सॉल्व सिंपली। हाउ टू फाइंड द जीरोज, you will put it equal to 0, then you will do factorization, you will take minus 8 into 1, 8 minus 8 factors such that minus 2 it will split. So you will get x square minus 4x plus 2x minus 8 equal to 0. As you are doing factorization, common x, x minus 4 will be left here, 2 common here, x minus 4 will be left. From these two terms, x minus 4 you will take common, you will get x plus 2 equal to 0. So either x minus 4 equal to 0 or x plus 2 equal to 0. From here you will get x is equal to 4 or x is equal to minus 2. So x is equal to 4 and x equal to minus 2 is the solution. So second part you have to tick. Second part you have to tick 4 minus 2. Second part you have to tick. Now the highway of overpass is represented graphically. Zeros of polynomial can be represented, can be expressed graphically. Number of zeros of polynomial is equal to number of points where the graph of the polynomial, you know only that zeros, whenever graph is there, zeros we are finding wherever that graph is touching the x-axis. So intersecting the x-axis will be the answer. So first part will be its option, intersecting at x-axis. Now C part C, graph of quadratic polynomial is a parabola. So already in question only in the theory part it is given only that it is parabola. So third part you will tick parabola. D part, representation of highway underpass whose 1 0 is 6, sum of zeros is 0 is. Now formula you will use, see here, formula is x square minus sum of zeros into x plus product of zeros. In quadratic equation you have already studied this formula, product of zeros. So x square minus 1 0 is 6 and sum of zeros is 0. So if 1 0 is 6, so sum is 0. So another you will take, suppose x equal to 0, x will come minus 6. So other 0 will come minus 6. So sum of zeros already 0 given, so you will put here 0. Product 6 and minus 6 product will come minus 36. So x square minus 36 is the answer. So x square minus 36, second option you will tick. Second option you will tick. Now E part, number of zeros of polynomial can have is. This is very interesting question. Number of zeros, already I told you, for finding zeros you have to put the term equal to 0. Whatever term is there you have to put the equal to 0. So x minus 2 whole square plus 4 is 0. So x minus 2 whole square is equal to minus 4. So x minus 2 will come under root of minus 4. And whenever in higher classes in plus 1, if you will take non-medical, you will study that minus 4 under root. If you will take maths as a subject in plus 1, you will know that if minus under root is there, it is coming in imaginary root. So imaginary value coming, that means not exist. Not exist up to this level, you can understand this, that not exist is there. So no zeros are there. So answer is no zero. So third part you have to tick. You have to tick third part. Now see question number 20, case study based for 100 meter race. A stopwatch was used to find the time that it took a group of students to run 100 meter. Now group of students are running 100 meter race. Time 0 to 20 seconds those who are running, they are 8. Number of students are 8. 20 to 40, 10 are there. 40 to 60, 13 are there. 60 to 80, 6 are there. And 80 to 100, 3 are there. So firstly, we will make the table. So time, you can write here x 0 to 20, 20 to 40, 40 to 60, 60 to 80, and 80 to 100. Like this, you can make the table. Now, number of students means, number means frequency. How many are there? So 8, 10, 13, 6, and 3. Now, suppose you will take this x1, you will take this as x. So fx, x is the middle value, 0 plus 20 over 2. So 10 will come, 20 plus 40 over 2, you will get here 30, middle value you want. So middle value 60 and 80, middle value 70, 80 and 100, middle value is 90. Now you have to find, because in first part you have to estimate the mean. You have to take estimate the mean you have to find. And mean formula is summation of fx over summation of f. So firstly you will find fx. Fx will come, f into x 80, 300, 650, 6 into 70, 420, and 3 into 90, 270. So summation of fx you will write here. Summation of fx you will write here. It will come, you will add them. When you will add them, you will get it 1720. And frequency also, summation of frequency means sum of frequency you want, you will add them, you will get 40. You will get 40. Now simple, you have to put in the formula 1720 over 40. 00 cancel. Now 172, when you will divide by 4, you will get 43. 4 fours are 16, and 1 will come here, 12 will come, 4 is a 12. So mean will come 43. So you have to take third part, third option, you have to take 43. What will be the upper limit of model class? Now model class, very easy to see. How to see model class? What you have to do? You have to see the maximum mode you are calculating by the maximum value. Now maximum value is 13. And you have to see the model class. This is model class 40 to 60. So upper limit of model class is 60. Upper limit means this one. Lower limit means this one. So upper limit you want, so 60. So third part you have to tick. 60 you have to tick. Now construction of cumulative frequency table is used in determining the, you know, only whenever you have to find the median. Whenever you have to find the median, you have to take the cumulative frequency CF. So median will be its option. So second option you have to tick. Now sum of lower limit of median class and model class. Model class already know, lower limit is 40. Now sum, so plus. Now for median class, already you know that you have to find CF. Already in previous part I told you want CF. Now what is CF? CF is cumulative frequency. First term is coming as it is. Second term is addition of these. 8 plus 10, 18 will come. Third term is diagonally also you can add. Otherwise these three you can add. 18 plus 13, what will come? 31. Now diagonally you can add, or all the four you can add. This will come CF here. So 37. 37 plus 3, 40. Cumulative frequency means that 0 to 20, 8 are there, and 0 to 40, 18 are there, 0 to 60, 31 are there, 0 to 80, 37 are there, 0 to 100, 40 are there. So this is cumulative frequency. Whenever you have to find the median or median class, you have to find CF or cumulative frequency. Now you see, now what you have to see, the median class you have to see. Now what you will see for this, you will see summation of f. Summation of f, it came 40 na, so 40 over 2 you will do, that will come 20. Now you have to take the value which is coming in 20 here, up to 18 coming na, that means 20 is coming in this class. Come 20 is coming in this class, matlab 20 se thoda sa jyada wala lena hai aapko. 20 se jyada is 31 na, थोड़ा ज़्यादा, 37 भी बड़ा है लेकिन जो मिनिमम ज़्यादा दैट यू हैव टू टेक. तो 31 यू हैव टू टेक एंड कॉरस्पॉन्डिंग टू दैट यू हैव टू सी द क्लास. क्लास इज 40 to 60. इन दिस केस ऑल्सो लोअर क्लासेस लोअर लिमिट इज और लोअर मॉडल क्लासेस 40, सो यू विल टेक 40. 40 + 40 = 80 विल कम. सो यू हैव टू टेक द थर्ड ऑप्शन 80. हाउ मेनी स्टूडेंट फिनिश द रेस विद इन 1 minute? नाउ सी हेयर, विद इन 1 minute. नाउ यू सी 1 minute मीन्स अप टू 60 seconds. 1 minute मीन्स अप टू 60 seconds. सो 8 + 10 + 13 यू हैव टू डू. 8 + 10 = 18. 18 + 13 = 31. सो वॉट विल कम? 31 विल कम इट्स आंसर. सो थर्ड पार्ट यू हैव टू टिक. आई होप यू अंडरस्टूड दिस क्वेश्चन. नाउ I will solve question section B, part B, question number 21. Part B, question number 21. Very easy question. 3 bells ring at interval 4, 7 and 14 minutes. All the 3 bells rings, firstly they ring at 6 a.m. When the 3 bells will ring together next? So whenever this type of question is there, you have to firstly take LCM off 4, 7 and 14. So LCM, I think all of you know how to find. You will find the LCM. Then I will tell what you have to do further. So LCM came 2 into 2, 4, 4 into 7, 28. So 28 minutes. As these all are in minute, you will take 28 minutes. So firstly, they toll together or bell together at 6 a.m. So now they will bell together or toll together after 6 + 28 minutes, that means 6:28 a.m. because 6 a.m. is there, here a.m. will come. So 6:28 a.m. is the answer. Now see question number 22. Very easy question of coordinate geometry. Find the point on x-axis which is equidistant from this type of question already came one. So one point is there which is on x-axis only, so y coordinate you have to take 0. Now you have to find distance between these two points. You will get x - 2 + 0 - 2 + 2² = x + 4² + 0 - 2². Now squaring both the sides you will get x - 2² 2² = 4 = x + 4². Again 2² = 4, so you can cancel. Now x² - 4x + 4 = x² + 8x + 16. x² cancel. Now -4x - 8x = 16 - 4, so -12x = 12. So x will come 12 over -12, that will come -1. Don't leave here. So required point will be -1 and 0 because you took x 0, x came -1, so required point will be -1, 0. Now optional question is there of this question number 22, that also of coordinate geometry, so we will solve that one. P is -2, 5, Q is 3, 2, they are the two points. Find the coordinate of point R on such that, like this, -2, 5 is there and 3, 2 is there. You have to take a point R such that PR ratio QR is 2:1. Now see carefully. This is 2, this is 1. This you have to see carefully that PR is upside, here 2 is there. So here you have to take 2. QR is downside and here QR is there, so you have to take 1. Corresponding you have to take. Now easy, only section formula. Suppose this is x1, y1, this is x2, y2. This is m1, m2. So m1, x2 plus m2, x1 over m1 plus m2. Then m1, y2 plus m2, y1 over m1 plus m2. So coordinates of R will come. By the formula, you can get 2 into 3 plus 1 into minus 2 over 2 plus 1 and 2 into 2 plus 1 into 5 over 2. 2 into 3, 6 and 1 into minus 2, minus 2 over 3. 2 into 2, 4 plus 1 into 5 over 2. So you will get, 3 will come here, no? 2 plus 1, 3. So 3 will come here. Now 6 minus 2 is 4, 4 over 3. 4 plus 5 is 9, 9 over 3. Now 3 threes are 9. So 4 over 3 and 3 is the answer. 4 by 3 and 3 is the answer. Okay. Now see question number 23rd. Question number 23rd you have to see. Find the quadratic animal. See, again the same type of question came. Quadratic polynomial whose zeros are 5, 3 root 2. This type of question firstly also came. So zeros are there. Firstly you will find sum. Sum will come 5 minus 3 root 2 plus 5 plus 3 root 2. Now minus 3 root 2 plus root 3 root 2 you will cancel. 5 plus 5, 10. Product you will find 5 minus 3 root 2 into 5 plus 3 root 2. A minus B into A plus B, you will get 5 square 25 minus, here 3 root 2 is there, minus 3 root 2 square. Now 25 minus 3 square is 9, root 2 square is 2, so 9 into 2, so 25 minus 18 will come, 25 minus 18. Now same formula, x square minus sum of zeros, x plus product of zeros. So this you have to find. Now x square minus sum of zeros, sum is 10 into x plus product is 25 minus 18, that will come 7, so plus 7 will come. So x square minus 10x plus 7 is the answer. So 23rd question you have to do like this. Okay, now question number 24th. Question number 24th, I will solve on the sheet because construction question is there. Construction question is there. See question number 24, draw a line segment AB of length 9 cm with A and B as center. Draw a circle of radius 5 cm and 3 cm respectively. Construct tangent to each circle from center of the other circle. Now see how to do this question. Firstly, what you have to do? You have to draw a line segment of length 9 cm. You have to draw a line segment of length 9 cm. You can use the scale and draw a line segment of 9 cm. Now you can give it name A and B. Now on A you have to draw a circle of radius 5 cm. So easily you can take here 5. So you have to draw a circle of radius 5 cm. So you can open the compass and draw a circle of radius 5 cm. Like this you can draw. See again, that was becoming wrong, so I made again because compass was loose. So you have to keep in mind this also, that compass should be tightly. Now AB is 9 cm. Now from A you have to mark 5 cm. You have to mark from A 5 cm so that you can make a circle of 5 cm up to here. Now carefully you have to make the circle from A, that is 5 cm. So like this you will get a circle. Now from B you have to make a circle of 3 cm. So you can mark here 3 cm. You can mark here 3 cm. And you can make a circle from here 3 cm from B point. Like this you can make a circle from point B. Now you have to make a tangent. Tangent आपको बनाना है दोनों centers से. So what is the method of making the tangent from both the center? Like ऐसे यहाँ से बनाना है, इस centers पे इस circle पे बनाना है, और इस center से इस circle पे बनाना है. So what is the method? So method is very easy. You have to remember it. You have to take perpendicular bisector of line segment AB. Perpendicular bisector means more than half. You will open and put an arc on both the side. Here also more than half you will open and put arc on both the side. Then with the help of scale, you have to join the points. Now like this, you will get a point here. Now from here, you have to take center and you have to take radius up to here. Because it is perpendicular bisector, so this and this will be same only. So you have to draw two cut here, because two tangent you want, so two cut here and two cut here, because here also you want two tangent. So you will get four cuts, 1, 2, 3, 4. Now from here you want tangent on this, so you will draw a line segment from here on this point such that it touches the circle at one point. And from here again on this circle you will make a tangent like this. Now from point B, from this center you want main tangent on this circle, so you will make a tangent like this. And here also you will make a tangent on the arc. So what you have to do? Firstly, line segment, you have to make 9 cm. From A you have to make 5 cm circle, from B you have to make 3 cm circle, then you have to make perpendicular bisector of AB, then you have to open this center up to A or B, then you have to make 4 arcs, then from this center you have to join this arc, from this center you have to join this arc, from this center you have to join this arc, from this center you have to join this arc. Means center किसी और circle का है और arc दूसरे circle का लेना है. Center किसी और circle का, arc दूसरे circle का लेना है. So like this you have to draw the tangent. So this was question number 24. Now question number 25. Very easy trigonometry. If 10A is equal to 3/4, 10A is 3/4. 10A you know it is perpendicular over base, means perpendicular is 3x and base is 4x. You have to find value of sine A. Sine A, perpendicular over hypotenuse. Hypotenuse will come perpendicular square plus base square. That means 3x square, 9x square plus 16x square. That means 25x square. This is hypotenuse square. So hypotenuse will come under root of 25x square. That means 5x. Here you have to take positive only, because length is always positive. Now sine A is perpendicular over hypotenuse, means 3x over 5x. So sine A came 3/5. Now you want cos A. Cos A is base over hypotenuse. Base is 4x and hypotenuse is 5x. So it will come 4/5. Now you want 1 over sine A plus 1 over cos A. 1 over sin A means 5/3, sin A ka ulta kar dena. 1 over cos A means cos A ka ulta kar dena, 5/4. You will take LCM, 3 and 4 LCM, 12. Now 5 4s are 20 and 5 3s are 15. So you will get 35 over 12. Yahan pe bhi chhod sakte ho, or you can write in mixed form also. So 2, 11/12 or 35/12 is the answer. Now optional question is there, that is also very easy. Optional question of trigonometry is very easy. In this, sine theta, root 3 sine theta minus cos theta is equal to 0, and theta is given greater than 0 and less than 90 degree. You have to find theta. So very easy, root 3, root 2 sine theta is equal to cos theta. So sin theta over cos theta. Cos theta ko idhar le aayenge, to nothing will be there, means 1 will be there, 1 over root 2. Now tan theta is equal to 1 over root 2. Sorry, here 3 is there. 3 is there. So what will come here? 3 will come. So 1 over root 3 kab hoti hai tan ki value? When is 30 pe? So tan 30. So theta will come 30 degrees. So theta is 30 degree. Now two more questions we will do today, up to 27 we will do, then remaining I will post tomorrow. So wait for that video. Ab isko is diagram mein dekh lo. Ek circle hai, and in a figure quadrilateral ABCD subscribing a circle. Subscribing means ABCD uske aas paas ek quadrilateral bana raha hai. Ye AB hai, ABCD ek quadrilateral bana raha hai circle ke aas paas. इफ रेडियस ऑफ सर्कल इज 10 सेंटीमीटर फाइंड वैल्यू ऑफ एक्स, एक्स की वैल्यू फाइंड करनी है। एक्स पूरा ये ए बी है, ए बी एक्स। अब इधर देखो ये 38 है, ये 27 है, दे आर टेंजेंट फ्रॉम सेम एक्सटीरियर पॉइंट सी। सो वॉट विल बी डी आर, डी आर विल बी डी सी माइनस आर सी। नाउ वॉट इज डी सी? डी सी इज इक्वल टू सी बी बिकॉज दे आर टेंजेंट फ्रॉम सेम एक्सटीरियर पॉइंट। इन क्वेश्चन में यू हैव टू राइट ऑल द रीजन्स, रीजन्स नहीं लिखोगे तो मार्क्स कट हो जाएंगे। डी सी की जगह आपने लिख दिया सी बी माइनस आर सी। अब देखो सी बी कितना दिया हुआ है, सी बी इज 38 और आर सी कितना दिया हुआ है 27, तो डी आर कितना आ गया 11, डी आर कितना आ गया 11, तो डी आर आ गया 11। अब आपको क्या फाइंड करनी है, वैल्यू ऑफ एक्स। एक्स के लिए आपको ए पी चाहिए और पी बी चाहिए, ए पी और पी बी चाहिए। अब आप देखो डी आर 11 आ गया और वेट आई एम डूइंग अगेन, सी आर और सी क्यू 27 है बिकॉज दे आर टेंजेंट फ्रॉम सेम एक्सटीरियर पॉइंट। ध्यान से देखो बेटे, बिकॉज दे आर टेंजेंट फ्रॉम सेम एक्सटीरियर पॉइंट सो दे आर इक्वल। नाउ सी क्यू, सी बी दिया हुआ है 38, सी बी पूरा दिया है 38, तो पहले आप क्या निकालोगे बी क्यू। बी क्यू इधर देखो, बी क्यू कितना है, सी बी माइनस क्यू सी, सी बी माइनस क्यू सी। सी बी दिया हुआ है 38 और क्यू सी कितना है, सी आर के बराबर सी क्यू और सी आर बराबर तेरा 27 आ गया, तो बी क्यू आ गया 11 सेंटीमीटर। अब बी क्यू और पी बी बराबर है, पी बी एंड बी क्यू देखो ध्यान से, इसमें पी बी एंड बी क्यू दे आर टेंजेंट फ्रॉम सेम एक्सटीरियर पॉइंट सो दे आर इक्वल। सो सेम रीजन विल कम, टेंजेंट फ्रॉम सेम एक्सटीरियर पॉइंट, तो पी बी कितना आ गया 11 ही आ गया पी बी भी, ठीक है पी बी 11 आ गया। अब आपको ये पूरा चाहिए ए बी, एक्स ए बी है, तो आप देखो कि ये 10 है, ये भी रेडियस है तो ये भी 10 हो गया, ठीक है। अब ये 10 है और ये 90 डिग्री, और रेडियस जो होते हैं वो भी टेंजेंट के परपेंडिकुलर होते हैं, तो ये सारे तीनों 90 है तो ये भी 90 हो गया, और ये भी 10 है और ये भी 10 है, मींस ये क्या बन गया स्क्वायर, क्योंकि सारे एंगल्स 90 डिग्री है और एडजेसेंट साइड्स भी 90 है, एडजेसेंट साइड्स भी 90 है, और ये वाली साइड ए और यहाँ तक और ए एस ये भी क्या है इक्वल है, टेंजेंट फ्रॉम सेम एक्सटीरियर पॉइंट। सो यू विल गेट, सी हियर यू विल गेट दैट दिस इज़ अ स्क्वायर। अगर ये स्क्वायर है तो ये वाली साइड इतनी कितनी हो गई, इतनी साइड 10 हो गई, क्योंकि स्क्वायर की सारी साइड्स इक्वल है, और ये आपने 11 निकाल ली, तो यू विल गेट x इक्वल टू जो ए बी के बराबर है, यू विल गेट 10 प्लस 11 दैट इज़ 21 सेंटीमीटर। अगर समझ आ गया ठीक है, अदरवाइज कमेंट बॉक्स में लिख देना, आई विल मेक सेपरेट वीडियो फॉर दिस क्वेश्चन। ओके, वन मोर क्वेश्चन वी विल सॉल्व टुडे। 27, प्रूव दैट 2 - √3 टू प्रूव 2 - 3 इज इरेशनल, और आपको गिवन क्या है कि √3 इज इरेशनल, √3 इरेशनल दिया हुआ है, और आपको 2 - √3 को इरेशनल प्रूफ करना है, 2 - √3 को आपने इरेशनल प्रूफ करना है। तो आपको कैसे करना है इसको, इन टाइप के क्वेश्चंस को करने के लिए आपको कॉन्ट्रडिक्शन लेना है, कॉन्ट्रडिक्शन लेना है, मीन्स लेट 2 - √3 इज अ रैशनल नंबर, ठीक है इस टाइप से करते हैं इस क्वेश्चन को। नाउ वी कैन फाइंड ये लिखना भी ज़रूरी है, को प्राइम नंबर्स ए एंड बी, वेयर बी इज़ नॉट इक्वल टू जीरो। अगर बी इक्वल टू जीरो होगा तो इन्फिनिटी आ जाएगा, इसलिए बी नॉट इक्वल टू जीरो लिखना ज़रूरी है। सच दैट 2 - √3 इज इक्वल टू ए बाई बी, अब ए बाई बी को इधर ले आओ, क्योंकि आपको रूट थ्री का पता है कि वो इरेशनल है, तो रूट थ्री को उधर ले जाओ, इसको सॉल्व कर लो। कुछ नहीं है, मीन्स वन विल कम, वन बी का एलसीएम बी आ गया, इधर आ जाएगा टू बी माइनस ए इज इक्वल टू रूट थ्री। अब टू बी माइनस ए ओवर बी इज इक्वल टू रूट थ्री आ गया। अब आप लिख दोगे कि ए एंड बी आर इंटीजर्स, इंटीजर्स है ना ये ए और बी, सिर्फ ज़ीरो नहीं हो सकता। तो वी गेट दैट टू बी माइनस ए ओवर बी इज रैशनल नंबर। ये कौन सा नंबर है? रैशनल नंबर, बट ये है इक्वल रूट थ्री के, देयर फोर रूट थ्री इज ऑल्सो रैशनल नंबर, इज ऑल्सो रैशनल नंबर, रूट थ्री इज ऑल्सो रैशनल नंबर विच कॉन्ट्रैक्ट्स अवर स्टेटमेंट, विच कॉन्ट्रैक्ट्स, क्योंकि हमें पता है कि रूट थ्री इरेशनल है, हमें पहले से पता है कि रूट थ्री इरेशनल है, विच कॉन्ट्रैक्ट्स अवर स्टेटमेंट, मतलब जो हमें गिवन है उसको कॉन्ट्रैक्ट कर रहा है, मतलब रिवर्स कर रहा है। देयर फोर टू माइनस रूट थ्री इज इरेशनल। सो इस टाइप ऑफ के क्वेश्चन को आपको अपोजिट लेके, कॉन्ट्रडिक्शन लेके करना होता है। थैंक यू।